In this session, we are discussing some string operation and the related functions. So they are like this. So one function is our length, which will take the string as input argument and which will find out the number of alphabets or characters residing in that given string. Next one is the substring, which will take three input arguments, that is my string, initial and length. Next one is the concatenation, that is one of the very important string operations. And the last one we are going to discuss, that is the indexing, that is text, comma, pattern will be the input arguments. So let us explain them with the proper example. So at first we are considering that str1 is one string variable which is holding Calcutta. str2 is another string variable which is holding university. So now length of str1 will give you 8. Length requires only one string as input argument. It is giving 8 because this particular word is having 8 characters. Length of this mango tree will be 10. If you go on counting, including this blank character in between mango and tree, I shall be getting 10 here. Now, substring str2, 3. In case of substring, I require the string, then initial, then length. So str2, 4, 3. Here we have considered that the first character place number is 1. But in different languages, it may not be 1, it may be 0. So it is language dependent. Here we are considering the first character is at the position index 1. Okay, now see. Substring str2, 4, 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So from the fourth place, how many characters? 3 characters, because it is the initial, that is a 4, and 3 is the length. So from the fourth place, I am having 3 characters. So that will be bhar. Then substring str1, 6, 100. So from the 6th character, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 means the first T. And 100 characters, you see 100 characters are not there. So that's why it will take up to the last character, without appending or prepending any blank characters. That is, no blank characters appended or prepended. It will just pick out, it pick up only the TTA, that part of this Calcutta, it will pick up. Now, we are going for the concatenation example. Here we are having this concatenation operator. We could have also have the concatenation function. In our C programming, we are having the strcat for the concatenation. So it may be a function, may be some operator. In case of Java, we use plus for the concatenation. In case of PLSQL, we use double filter for concatenation. It is totally language dependent. So you are having str1 concatenation operator, one blank character enclosed within double quotes. So here we are having one blank, and then str2. So we will be having Calcutta, one blank, and then university. In this way, the strings are getting concatenated. So data, one blank space, concatenation operator, structure. So you'll be getting data structure here. So that is our string concatenation. Okay. The last one is the indexing. Should have two input arguments. One is the text, another one is the pattern. So text here is str1, that is this. I'm searching for CUTTA. So CUTTA can be obtained from the fourth place. I have considered the first character is the place number 1. If I could have considered that one 0, then obviously it will be the 012. So it will be the third place in that case. It will be returning 3 in that case. But here, as I consider the first character is at the position 1, so it will be returning 4. So index is actually searching this particular substring from the main string. Okay. Index str2iver. So str2iver means this one. So that is the third. 1, 2, 3. From the third place it is getting. So it is 3. But in case of str2, if I try to find out or search India, if I trying to search out this India, as India is not present, it will give me 0. So these are the basic string operations. So one is length, which will calculate the number of characters in the string, including the blank character also. Substring, which will retrieve a portion of the string. From the very name substring, it is quite obvious. Concatenation means it will add two strings. And indexing means it will search a pattern in a main text or string, and it will find out the position or the location number or the index number from where the pattern has been found. If the searching is unsuccessful, then it will return value 0. So this much we have considered here. So accordingly, in the next video, we shall go for string operations. In this video we have discussed. In the next video, we will be going for string processing. So in the string processing, I might be using these basic string operations. Okay, so I have considered them accordingly, and accordingly I shall be using them in string processing. Please watch the next video where we are discussing different types of string processing techniques. Thanks for watching this one.